is, as I said, head of the construction division of the Ministry of Defense. He's a mechanical engineer by training, very strong background in CAD and CAD-CAM. And that is, while you're getting ready, I will tell everyone that a few years back, perhaps three years back now, Erez invited us to, as researchers, to his office, and he said, "Tell me, what's this BIM thing?" And we explained, and he said, "No, that explanation's too long. Are you talking about modeling buildings in the way that mechanical engineers model cars and machines?" We said, "Well, yes, essentially." He said, "Fine, I want it." And I think that pretty much sums it up. So Erez will tell us a little bit about adoption of BIM in Israel. I think that the impact of the announcement by the Ministry of Defense has been by far the most important event in Israel's development of BIM and in the adoption of BIM.
Okay, good afternoon. My name is Erez. I'm the head of the engineering and the construction department in the Ministry of Defense, and you probably ask for yourself, what does the Ministry of Defense has to do with BIM technology? So one of my officers is sitting there, is called Uri, and he engaged me, Professor Rafael Zaks, and we started a new, I don't know how to call it, a new change in our organization, and I think we're dragging with us a very big part of the AEs in the State of Israel and the contractors. What is the role of our organization? We're building, maintaining, we're the statutorical authority of the Ministry of Defense and the IDF all over the country. We're building everything you can think about it, from airports to ports, like here in Haifa for the new vessels of the Navy, the borders of Israel, the checkpoints of Israel, the camps. We're moving the camps from the center of the country. Now this is our biggest project. We're moving the biggest camps in the center of the country from Tel Aviv area to the south, east, wherever you want, just not in the center of the country, in order to let the population and grow and have apartments in the center of Israel. We found the BIM as a very big and very strong tool to manage our projects, and it has a very big importance for us in a lot of categories, and I'll go into details. We wrote the designation with our with Uri and Rafael, and we decided that we want to change the way we design our project and manage all the building on the field from 2D design to BIM. It's a very, very big challenge, and I think we do it till now very good. It's a very big challenge, and I'll tell you why types of building. You can think of everything you see in the civilian side. We build in the army and the MOD side, all the classified and the special structures, office, dinings, barracks, warehouse, industrial facilities needed for the MOD and the army, data centers, ports, airports. Think about the F-35 that landed here in Israel a year ago. We're building all the facilities for this airplane, the new vessels, war rooms, borders, all what's happening all over the country. A very, very big challenge. We're managing projects in the total sum of something like above 35 billion shekel. In shekels, in FMS. FMS is $1.08 from the United States in order to help the MOD and the IDF. And with such a big amount of money, you have a lot of power. You can move and do a big change in the Israeli market, in the construction, construction Israeli market. And 3 years ago, we decided to use the BIM technology. And once we started, we found a lot of things that we need to take care of. First, our staff didn't know how to manage with this BIM technology. Till today, part of our people don't know how to manage with this BIM technology. Last night, I had a meeting with Solel Bonnet, one of the best project managers of Solel Bonnet. And we had a first meeting, initiation meeting of a very big project in the south. And the first thing he said, I'm going to design, it's a design build project. And the first thing he said, I'm going to design all this project in BIM. Get ready. Why get ready? Because our staff and their staff need to know how to talk together. It's a very big challenge in the state of Israel in these days. In this case, it's funny because we started talking with Solel Bonnet 2 years ago about the BIM technology and started to make them interested in this technology. They're learning very fast, and it's not something that is regular in the contract between the contractors, because not many of them like the BIM technology. But the big companies are now in the direction of the BIM, and once we started working with the BIM, we found a few challenges. First, the management. We need to change our the way our managers, the project managers, the field people, the way they think, the way they manage their discussion, decisions, contracts. The contracts are different. We had a lot of dilemmas. How to write the contract between us and the AEs, between us and the contractors. We overcome about these challenges, but we're doing a lot of tests and learning from our from organization from abroad. We work a lot with a corps of engineers. It's a very big organization of the U.S. Army, similar to us, that builds all over the world and use BIM all over the world. Suddenly, we found that the time schedule is different when you use BIM. The time that you need to design is faster. The decisions you need to take are shorter in time. You bring the customer to one room, and after 10 months, a project of, let's say, $500 million is closed. And you're in the, you find yourself in a bid process. And we were shocked because of the short time. And suddenly, the way the contractor talks in the field is different. Suddenly, they found themselves with small changes. Someone that, if ever, I know part of you work with contractors, you know that changes in project are the biggest money in the project. And in this case, you suddenly hear from the contractor that they don't find, they almost don't find changes. And it's a different way of thinking. We started thinking about combining BIM in maintenance. It's a very big challenge. You have to understand that we possess something like 10 million square meters all over the country. We need to maintain it. It's a very big challenge. Very complicated facilities. Think of all the laboratories, data centers, and et cetera, ammunition facilities. Very big challenge of maintaining all these facilities. We're in the beginning of it. Standardization. We found ourselves building, we call it a big room. I don't know how you call it, big room. Okay, so we have our own big room inside our headquarters. And we stopped designing standard buildings. In this big room, we design a lot of standard buildings, barracks, office, classrooms, dining facilities, etc., etc. And the project manager doesn't design it anymore. He comes to this big room, take this design, fit it to the site, and that's it. Sometimes projects are finished in weeks instead of designing half a year. And training. Training is the biggest challenge. Taking an organization of something like 500 people and training them to work in BIM, and dragging also AEs and the contractors to start working in the BIM technology, this is the biggest challenge. We set a few teams. We're working with a contractor union, with our managers. We had a lot of challenges in the computing, maintenance, GIS. We're trying to combine the GIS and the BIM. And we started doing pilots. Pilots of several types of projects. And we're still doing a lot of pilots to find what is the optimal way to use BIM in our project. Is it smart to use BIM in every project? The answer is probably no. We had a lot of questions if to use the BIM in infrastructures, and it works very well. Skip it. This is a slide showing what's happening today with AE companies over Israel, and it's growing from day to day. We had a very big decision to take. We can be passive and wait for the market to change and start working in BIM. And we can be active. And we decided to be active. So we started implementing the BIM technology inside of the AE contracts and inside the bids of construction. And we started making a big change in the market. A lot of AE companies, part of them are sitting here, starting to design in the BIM technology. And there's a great change today in the market. The biggest challenge is not the AE companies, it's the contractors. The contractors are behind. Most of them don't know what to do with the BIM technology in Israel, but we're pushing them as much as we can. And the big big contractors are in Israel are starting in this day to do the change. We had an external team, an internal team. We stated from everywhere we could. A statement, and we stated that we are going to use a BIM, and we call the designers and we call the contractors to take part in it. Uri and Rafael wrote an initial BIM guide. We started, where is Yuval? I saw Yuval with engineering. Had a course that is, I think it's the third time that it's happening for our project managers, training them how to use a BIM. And internal is not a simple mission. We had to train our staff, control all this process every 2 months. We're having a big status with all the relevant people in our organization that are taking care of this BIM change and I think we need to write an Israeli standard. Uri started it and we're going on with it. I know there is a British standard, but it's time to write an Israeli standard the same way as being done abroad. Dealing with the role of the BIM manager, modes of collaboration, how to qualify the designers, how to deal with maintenance, simulation, and payment. There's a big change in our contracts because of this BIM. The pricing is different. We need to encourage excellence. The time schedule is different, so we have to pay different. And we're developing now a standard, a form of a contracts for the AEs and the contractors. Every week, in every big site, we're having a status meeting. The status meeting looks totally different. This is a picture taking in a site in the south of the country. The contractor is Electra, and our field people, and they're looking on a status on a BIM model. That's the way they're doing it, instead of Excel charts and other old technologies. They're looking at the model and finding what is the status, what are the problems, and we're now writing the Bible of how to do it right while construction. It's not something that is working as a standard in Israel. Electra is a very strong contractor. I think it's one of the two biggest contractors in Israel, and she's learning together with us, and we're developing the system how to take this site and copy it to the other sites all over the MOD sites all over the country. It's a very, very big change for us. I talked about the standardization. This is a simulation of one of the buildings where we developed for the army. It can be barracks, it can be office, it can be defects, everything we need. And the project manager doesn't have to waste time and money in order to have his project on time. Dilemmas. What is the type of project we want to use the BIM technology? We are not in a situation that everything can be done in BIM, so we're challenging the designers every time to go on and dipping the BIM technology. We didn't use BIM in retrofit, but we think it must be used. What is the position of the project manager and the model manager? We have to find the balance between the two of them. There is only one manager for the project. Well, I had a discussion with Uri and Rafael because Uri described as a model manager above all. And it's not right from my point of view. The model manager and all the designers are below the product manager. He's responsible for the time, money, etc. He has a very strong tool called the model manager, but that's it. Only one integration with other organization. We are talking with a union of contractors, trying to drag them as much as we can into this BIM change. The AEs companies, most of them are in the way. We're talking with, I don't know how you say it, in Misrad HaBinoy VaShikon, Netive Israel, and et cetera, et cetera. And I talk about the Engineering Association and the Contractor Association. Future direction, I talked about the BIM standard, GIS and BIM. We have a model, the first model that combines two of them. We have, you know, it's called Bad Ehad in Mitzpe Ramon. We have a model of the very big building that we're going to build there inside the GIS maintenance and how to manage this BIM projects, supervision. We have to train our staff how to manage these sites in the BIM decade. And using, you have to understand that we have a lot of problem with classification of projects. We can't use the cloud technology as in the other civilians. So we are building big rooms inside our facilities, and every classified project found itself inside one of these facilities. It's a dilemma. It's a very big dilemma because we want the AEs to bring their best people into this big room, and that's it. If anyone have a question, I'd be happy to answer.
All right, given that Erez does need to leave, if anyone does have a question, I guess now would be a good time to ask, because we able to stay. Any question?
We're thinking about, you know, every organization in Israel need a catalog, list of BOQ, I don't know how you call it. Yeah, BOQ. And the vision is to have a BOQ, very big one, with a BIM model of the elements in order to make the AEs faster and use standardization. Starting, I know that there are manufacturers that use the BIM technology to model their products. The challenge is to connect between the BOQ and the element and have all the AEs all over the country have the same standard. Okay? It's a vision, but it will reach it. Okay. Yes.
That's one more question. No, okay. No, final question.
Why do you need to write a new code? Why can you implement the UK code?
I think the Israeli market has its own behavior, and we need to fit the standard to the needs of the state of Israel. I'm not sure that the standards from abroad fits all the demands. I think that when you're talking about BIM, there's a community. There are three people, the customer, us, the AEs, and the contractors. All of them need to speak in a language that fits to their behavior. I'm not sure that the standards from the United States or UK fits to Israel. I read the BIM standards of the Corps of Engineers. It doesn't fit to Israel. If I use it, most of the AEs will give it back and say, thank you, we're going back to the 2D. We need to find something that fits the way our market behaves.
I think that's
correct. That's a very, very big question. You want to answer, Uri? We had a very big discussion inside our organization, what to do. Do we give the contractor our model? Do we ask the contractor to develop his own model because it's responsibility? And we decided to give him the model and we ask him to develop his own model. Why? We compare. Every day we compare our model to his model and we have a reference. So we know if he understands the project as needed and according to our specification, or he doesn't understand the project and we stop him immediately. You know, we had a lot of types of supervisor, electricity, construction, sewage, etc., etc. And now we had a new category, a BIM supervisor from our side. And there's a modelist from the side of the contractor, and they're talking together.
Ernest, thank you very much.